Recall, we had defined an alphabet to be a set of symbols, a finite set of symbols, and as an example, we could have taken 0 or 1 or A, B, C, D through Z or any other set of symbols, finite set of symbols that you choose to have. Then we also defined sigma star to be, this was defined to be the set of all finite strings over sigma. So, in case our sigma is just these two, 0 and 1, then sigma star for this, sigma star is the set of all finite binary strings. And another notion that we defined last time was the notion of a language. We said a language L over the alphabet sigma is a subset of sigma star. And throughout this course, one theme that will continue is that we will consider various languages and see how we can solve the membership problem of these languages. Recall, if I have a language L, then the membership problem for L is given a string X to decide if X is in L. And today we'll take a very simple, very intuitive way of solving these problems for a class of languages. And we'll do that. In fact, all these membership problems that we'll be solving will define some machines or grammars, and these terms will be clear as we go by. So, we will define something and we will show that this machine or this grammar will be able to, if you use that, then you will be able to solve the membership problem of this language or that language. And as I said, today our topic is finite state machines. Machines, when we talk of machines, of course, we do not really mean machines like lathe machines or drilling machine, but machine in the sense things we do mechanistically. And you will see that these are also kinds of very specified kinds of algorithms, and best will be when we go through some example machines, then we will be clear what we mean by machines possibly. Incidentally, these are also called, which we are going to study today, finite state automata. The word automata is the plural of the word automaton. This is singular and plural form is automata. Basically, they mean what we mean machines in our context. All right. So, let me introduce the notion of finite state automata or finite state machines through an example. I will introduce the notion of finite state machines or finite state automata through a very simple example. So, our example is going to be a language over this sigma, which is just 0 and 1, and let me say the language is the set of, let me write it in this way, all strings x which are in 0, 1 star. Immediately then I know I am talking of finite binary strings such that x has even number of zeros. Okay. So, this language is very clear that, for example, if I take this string, this is in this language. Reason? It has 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. If I just take a string of 1s, this is also in the same language L, because the number of zeros in this is 0, which is an even number. So, this is in L. On the other hand, if I take something like 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, this has 1, 2, 3, 4, and then suppose I put another 0. This is not in the language because this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. Which language? This is the language we are discussing. Of course, you will say that this is a very trivial problem. I will just count the number of zeros, and if that count happens to be even, then I will say that string is in the language. Otherwise, it is not. Yes, you could do it that way. However, we will restrict ourselves so that we motivate us towards this notion of finite state automata by saying that, look, the way you have to do this, make this decision, solve the membership question of this problem, this language is this. That when the string is given to you, you will start scanning from the left end. Okay. So, let me write it down. Start scanning the string from its left end, go over the string one symbol at a time, and when you come to the end of the string, when the string is over, you know, start, when your the scanning process as you are going from left end and you are going down, 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 when you go beyond the string, that means when you scan the entire string, your answer should be ready. To be ready with the answer, as soon as the string is entirely scanned. All right. So, think of the string. What we are saying is, he will start from the left end. So, right in the beginning you will see a 0, and then you will come to this symbol, then this symbol, then this symbol, and so on. By the time you finish scanning the string, entire string, your answer should be ready. An answer about what? Answering that whether this string belongs to the language L, that means whether it has even number of zeros or not, thereby solving the membership problem for this language. If we think a little bit, the way to do this would be, one way to do this would be satisfying these constraints, that what at any given time after scanning some prefix of the string, I will remember whether the number of zeros I have seen so far is even or odd, right. So, in the beginning you have, when you started, you have not seen anything. So, you know, imagine you are just about to start scanning the string from the left end. So, therefore, you have not seen any symbol. So, at that time, how many zeros have you seen? You have seen zero number of zeros, right. So, then that time your state of the mind is that I have seen zero zeros or even number of zeros. Then when you see the first symbol here, in this case it happens to be a zero. So, then when you finish scanning this symbol, your state of the mind will be that I have seen so far an odd number of zeros. Then you will scan, so let me write this, in the beginning you had seen even number of zeros, that will be true for beginning of any string. When I say beginning, that means when I have not seen anything. Of course, that means I have seen the empty string which has zero symbols, and therefore it has even number of zeros. So, I will say initially the state of my mind as I am doing this is that I have seen even number of zeros. When I see this zero, then I say that look, now I have seen odd number of zeros. Then I see a 1, my state of mind does not change because I have seen for this first part, this 0 and 1, I have seen odd number of zeros. Then again another 1 comes, even now I have seen only odd number of zeros. And then when I scan this one, I say that my state of mind, if you allow me to say it that way, that my state of mind is that now that I have seen even number of zeros. Again, my state of mind does not change. I have seen even number of zeros, I have seen even number of zeros, I have seen even number of zeros. Now, when I finish scanning this, I have seen odd number of zeros. Now, when I come here, I have seen even number of zeros, right. So, I have, as and when I finish scanning this entire string, I know that number of zeros in this string was even. On the other hand, supposing my string was 10110001. So, again if we do it that way, in the beginning I have seen nothing. So, even number of zeros I have seen, even number of zeros I have seen. Here when I finish scanning this symbol, odd number of zeros, even number of odd number of zeros, odd number of zeros, after this even number of zeros, odd number of zeros, odd number of zeros. So, it is possible to satisfy these constraints and be able to decide whether or not the string which was given to me has even number of zeros or odd number of zeros. So, let me see what we are doing through a picture or a diagram. Let me say that my mind had two states so far as this problem is concerned. In this state, I have seen even zeros. Here, I have seen odd zeros, right? And how do I go from one state to another? Because you see, a symbol came. And when I, after scanning that symbol, I may, depending on whether it was 0 or 1, I may change the state of my mind. So, for example, in case a 1 comes, I am here, that is, I have seen even number of zeros and a 1 comes. Should I change my state? No, because even then I have seen only an even number of zeros. So, what this means is, suppose I have scanned so far a prefix of the string which has even number of zeros, and then I scan another symbol which is a 1, still clearly I have seen only even number of zeros. So, therefore, I come back to the same state. And you will see this, if I use in this manner, if a 0 comes, then if I had seen so far even number of zeros, I will come here, my state of mind will see, will record that I have seen odd number of zeros, and here if I see a 1, I will remain in the same state of mind. And if I see a 0 here, then of course, previously I had seen so far odd number of zeros, one more 0 came, therefore, I have seen even number of zeros. So, I move back and forth from state to state, there are just only two states. In my mind, to do this problem, suffices that we keep just this two states of mind. And as and when a symbol comes, I may or may not change my state depending on what the symbol was, right. Now, you see in the beginning I said that when this process of scanning the input string starts, where am I, which of these two states? I will be here, because I had not seen anything. So, therefore, I had seen 0 zeros. So, I am in this state, and so this state is where this whole process begins. So, let me identify this state in this manner, an arrow coming from nowhere, right. In this picture, it means in the beginning, initially, we are here in this state. And when I end, I will say the string is in the language. Remember, the language was the set of all strings which has even number of zeros. if after finishing scanning the string, if I happen to be in this particular state. So, the state in which or the set of states in which if I am in after scanning the entire string, if those states are such that they signal to me that the string is in the language, such states also need to be marked spatially, like as in this case, and we will just put distinguish such states by making a double circle. Okay. You will agree that whatever it is, this picture tells me the way of deciding whether a binary string has even number of zeros or not. But in this manner, when it's starting my scanning from the left end, going symbol by symbol, and by the time I end scanning the entire string, I have my decision. So, let us just see the components of the kinds of things that we have seen in this very simple example. We had these two things, and I have been telling that these are my states of mind for this problem. So, we have some states. So, component one of this picture is a set of states. And how many states? Well, it does not matter. In this case, there are two, but such a set, I'll make use the notation capital Q that will denote the set of states in pictures like this. Then what did we have in this picture? If you see, I had these zeros and ones, and this marked here 0 0 1 1, and they are what? They are the symbols of my alphabet. So, of course, we will see many more examples of these kinds of diagrams, but even for this diagram it is clear that what I put next to an arrow is a symbol of my alphabet. And you see, if you are in some state, then clearly any of those symbols from your alphabet can be the next symbol, right? We are in this state, a 0 may come or a 1 may come, right? So, here we have this alphabet, which is the input, right? Input alphabet. And as usual, we will call it capital sigma. Then, very important thing is the rule for going from state to state. What do we do? I mean, what is this idea that we are in some state, a symbol comes, like we are in this state, the symbol 0 came, then we move to this state. So, this is called state transition. Now, whatever is in this picture, I can think of that I have a mapping delta. This is called transition function. And this transition function, what is it doing? What is it telling me? That if I am in some state and a symbol comes, which is the next symbol of the input, then which is the state I will go to? So, this is a mapping whose domain is the product of the set of states and the set of symbols, and the range is the set of states. Now, let me name these states this way. So, let me say this is this state. what I had written here is for my own understanding, but in general I will give some names like Q0, Q1. So, my two states in this example, Q was, capital Q was Q0 and Q1, and your delta will look like this, something like, you can imagine the delta is a mapping which is taking the present state and the symbol seen, and here I have next state. Right? This is your. So, if the present state it state is Q0, and if I see 0, then next state is Q1. If the present state is Q0, if I see a 1, I remain in the same state Q0. If the present state is Q1, I see a 0, I go to the state Q0, and if I am in the state Q1 and the symbol is 1, and then we go to the state, we remain in the same state, right? This completely specifies the transition function as we have used in this example. Now, let us just generalize this. We will see a finite state automaton FSA and FSAM is in this manner. What are the components it has? Q, sigma, delta, but you know there are some other things in this diagram which so far I have not put down. What are the other two things? One is where I started from. So, I here in this diagram, this arrow coming from nowhere represented that state I was initially. So, my fourth component is initial state and the final component is of that in this picture. Like in this case, this state Q0 was specially marked to signal that if I end here, that means the string is in the language. So, there can be a number of states which are like that. All those states, so let me write this here, set of states ending at which means string in language. Okay. So, there are five, really if you look at this, that there are all these five components were there and nothing more. The set of states, the input alphabet sigma, a transition function which I specified diagrammatically here, delta, and then an initial state, let me call it Q0, and this set of states ending at which means string is in L. There is a name for this kind of set states, they are the set of final states or accepting states. So, let me write these components, set of states, alphabet, input alphabet, is the state transition function. This is the initial state. Is it one? Initial state is not a set. It is just one unique state where you start, and this is the set of final states or accepting states. See, these set of states ending at which means string is in L, this F, let me call it as accepting or final states. Okay. One important thing to say, an FSA, there is this word finite is there. What does this finite mean? This means, very importantly, Q is a finite state, finite set. In other words, this machine may have maybe 1 million states, you know, not this particular one, but in general, but the number of that number of states, total number of states is something finite. So, in other words, this is what I am trying to say is an FSA or finite state automaton M is something which has these five components, a set of states, an input alphabet, state transition function, the initial state and the set of accepting states. And you can see some of the relationships that we have. We have already mentioned them. One is that, of course, we say that Q, cardinality of Q is finite. So, Q is a finite set. Sigma is, of course, is also finite, is a finite set of symbols. Now, what was delta? Delta was a map from Q cross sigma to Q. And see that Q is finite, sigma is finite. So, this map can be specified by a table like this. Excuse me. If this had 100 states, Q had, there were 100 states, there were 10 symbols, then how many entries would I have in this table? This can take 100 values, this can take 10 values. So, total number of entries in this will be 1000, right? For every state symbol pair, I should tell what is the next state is. So, delta is a mapping, and therefore, you can see this is also something very finite. And depending on the size of Q and sigma, the size of delta is there. I mean, that it is thereby determined. And Q 0, the initial state, is an element of Q, and F, the accepting or the final set of final states, is a subset of Q. Okay? Right. So, now, all this may at this point of time seem very artificial, because a very trivial problem that we did, and from there we are generalizing, but let us see a few more examples to fix this idea of finite state machines. So, my next language that I will consider, for which I will provide again another finite state automaton, is slight generalization of this same problem. So, my next language is L1, which is also a language over the binary alphabet. So, this is set of all strings over the binary alphabet, right. So, immediately I am saying it once more, that immediately I know an x is a finite binary string, and now x has even number of zeros. And has even number of ones. Let me rub this out, but we should remember what we are trying to do. We are trying to give a finite state automaton which will solve the decision problem of this set L1, and I specify a finite state automaton by providing some machine M which has these 5 components Q, sigma, delta, Q0 and F. And the problem at hand is, can I give a machine M which will accept, or I am using a word which will I will define a little later, but basically what I am trying to say is the same thing, that I want to give a finite state automaton such that this, when this automaton finishes scanning this. Remember, our game is that whatever string is given, we start from the left end, right. Supposing this is the string, start from the left end, scan symbol by symbol, and then when I come here, my decision is already made. Decision in this case, whether or not the string that I have seen so far, when I have seen it entirely, whether it has even number of zeros as well as even number of ones. And we would like to do it in the same style. So, let us think, if we again go back to our old picture, that for solving this problem. So, our problem is, we have this language L1, and we would like to define an FSA, finite state automaton, which will be such that when that automaton finishes scanning the string which is given to it, any string which is given to it as an input, this automaton will be in a state which will signal to me whether the string has even number of zeros and even number of ones, right. So, we kind of extend our old idea. Let us think that what are the so called states that I need to be able to do this. So, again the same idea will generalize, we will say that look, supposing I have a string like 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 0 1 0. So, if I have come here, that is I have seen a prefix of the string, I will remember whether I have seen even number of zeros and even number of ones, or even number of zeros and odd number of ones. So, let us see what are the possibilities. Supposing I am here, what are the possibilities that could be? Either I have seen so far even zeros, even ones, even zeros, odd ones, odd zeros, odd ones and odd zeros, even ones. You will agree that any binary string will fall in one of these. And what more, you see, for example, here this string has even number of zeros and even number of ones, and now I see the next zero. Then what happens? It means immediately I have seen an odd number of zeros. When I finish scanning this particular symbol, I have seen an odd number of zeros, and since number of ones did not change, I have seen an odd number of zeros and even number of ones. So, we can actually do this way, that let me have these four states, even zeros, even ones and odd zeros, even ones, odd zeros, odd ones, and here even, let's say odd zeros, odd ones. So, what is the one which is left? Even zeros, even ones, odd zeros, even ones, odd zeros, odd ones, even zeros and odd ones, even zeros, odd ones, right. So, here a zero comes. We are in this state of mind, a zero comes. Then what happens? Clearly, this is the situation. Similar is the situation. I had scanned the string up to this. I have seen even number of zeros and a zero came. So, clearly now, if a zero comes, the number of ones do not change. So, still I will have seen only even number of ones, but now because of this zero, total number of zeros I have seen is odd. And you can see, if from here, if we have seen odd number of zeros and even number of ones and another zero came here, then I would have, my state of mind would be that I would have seen even number of zeros, even number of ones, right. And what about here? If I see a zero, of course, we have taken care of, and here if I see a one, what happens? Even number of zeros, the number of zeros will remain zeros, but if I see a 1, that means number of ones I would have seen will be odd. So, even zeros and odd ones is the state I will go to if I see a 1 here. From here, if I see a 1, what happens? I will go here clearly. Right. Now, in this state, this means so far I have seen odd number of zeros and odd number of ones. If I see a 0, then I will come here. See, I have seen so far odd number of zeros and odd number of ones. One more 0 came. So, therefore, I would have seen now even number of zeros and odd number of ones. And if I see a 1 in state of mind or whatever you call it, then I will go to this state. See, I had odd number of zeros, odd number of ones, one more 1 came. So, odd number of zeros, even number of ones. And now you can complete the picture. Even number of zeros, odd number of ones, if a 0 came, then I will go to odd number of zeros and even odd number of ones. And here, if a, so this is a 0 and this is, this arrow will be there, because if there are even number of zeros and odd number of ones and 1 came, and then I would be in seen even number of zeros and even number of ones. So, of these I have specified, so this has 4 states, sigma is of course 0 and 1. These diagram clearly tells me what delta is, the transition function. But what about the initial state? Clearly, when I have initially I have seen the empty string which has even number of zeros and even number of ones. So, this is the initial state. Which are the states in which, if I am in at the end of the scan and the string is in the language, it has even number of zeros and even number of ones. You can see this is the only state which should be marked like that. So, for this example, I have now, again I will rub these things out, because this was for my convenience. I will say this is Q 0, this is the state Q 1, this is, let me say, Q 2, small q 2, and this is Q 3. So, the machine for L 1, M for L 1, one machine, there may be many others, but at least this one has Q is Q 0, Q 1, Q 2, Q 3. Delta is, you know, you can work, you can just translate this picture into a table like the one I did before. For example, here again I will have now this, let me give you a couple of lines of this. If the present state is Q 0, present input symbol is 0, then my next state is going to be Q 1. So, in this manner you can complete the rest of the table. And how many entries this table will have? Q has 4 states, sigma has 2 symbols. So, for each pair of state and symbol, I need a line here. So, it will have totally 8 lines. And this is delta. You can complete this. And remember, what was Q 0? The initial state. Q 0 is the initial state for this machine. And the set F consists again only of the state Q 0. Right. Now, before we take up other examples, let me formalize a little bit more. I told you what an FSA will define. We'll define these FSAs to be. It has 5 components, but this business about when to say the string is in the language, that was kind of left somewhat vague. So, let me make that a little more formal. Let me specify it in a manner which is totally unambiguous. So, remember what delta was. Delta was a mapping from Q cross sigma to Q. But you see, actually I can extend this mapping to define a one which, if I am in some state and then a string comes instead of a symbol, after scanning that string from that state, starting from that state, which state I shall be. So, let me put it this way, delta hat is the function which tells the state the machine, the automaton will be after scanning the string, some string x, starting from the state Q. Formally, what is delta hat? What is the domain and range? Delta hat is a function which, starting from a some state, if you give a string. Now, what is the notation for any string or set of all strings, finite strings? Of course, these strings are over the alphabet sigma. So, this is, so this means state and a string. So, I am given a state, I have given a string, and what is the state the automaton will be. So, delta hat, the domain is state string pair and the range is going to be a state. So, for example, in this, supposing I am in Q1 and the string that came is 1101, which is the state I am going to be in? Oh, I did not, right. So, Q1, then 1 came, so I am here, then another 1 came, I am here, then a 0 came, remember I will take this edge, then a 1 came, then I am here. So, actually this picture tells me even that information, starting from any state, given any string, where the machine or where the automaton will be after scanning that string, starting from this state, right. You can see this and you can do it for any string, but can we do it formally? Can we define this function delta hat given the function delta? And that is not too difficult. So, I want to define this function for all strings, which is an infinite set, all finite strings over sigma. So, this is an example of an inductive definition. So, inductive definitions, you have seen other examples that we start from a base case and then say that suppose I have the definition for something, what happens when I get the next bigger one, bigger object. So, here the objects are strings and what is the smallest string, which is epsilon, right. So, can we answer this, that suppose I am in the state Q and the string is epsilon. Epsilon is, of course, has no symbols. So, therefore, the machine will remain in this state. So, therefore, it is should be Q. And now, this is the base of the inductive definition. and the now should be inductive part of the definition. In case of string, I have some string already for which I know, suppose I know the answer, and then a symbol came A. So, x is a string, A is a symbol, right. So, I would like to define delta hat starting from q x A. What is this? Well, let me say inductively, of course, I know delta hat of q on x. So, this means what? The state in which the machine will be starting from q and when the string is x. And now, a symbol has come, another symbol. And what is that symbol? Which is A. So, do you see that this is going to be delta hat q x A is equal to delta of, now this is a state and A, right. This is not difficult to see. What I am saying is really what this says, that if you know the state the machine is going to be after seeing the string x, then that state when the symbol A came from that state is the state where that machine will be, is the state where the machine will be on this entire string x A, right. So, this is not difficult. But the reason for doing this is that now I have, it is convenient that I have extended delta, which was, delta was a mapping from q cross sigma to q, and now I have extended it to q cross sigma star. Now, I do not need this, but what I am trying to define is now that given any automaton like that q sigma delta q 0 f, I can define a language which is like this lm. To be set of all strings from this alphabet such that delta hat q 0 x is an element of this set F. Using this delta hat, we are defining a language which is associated with this machine M. Let me just write it now like this, L of L in bracket M, which is this. And the idea is that this L is the language accepted by this machine M. So, you see, given any machine, using this, I can, using the concept that we have just defined, I can associate a language with that machine, which is the set of strings accepted by M. Now, what we are going to do from now on for some time when we are discussing this, that you will give me a language. And my job will be to find a machine M. So, let us say you have given me a language L 1. So, you can see this is a legitimate problem. To find FSA finite state automaton M 1 such that language accepted by this machine M 1 is this language L 1 that you gave me. So, in that sense, M1 is going to be a description of the language that you have given me. M1 is going to be a very simple algorithm to decide the membership question for the language L1. We'll continue this in the next lecture.